Oh, wait, I left something. I feel like I had changed that. Be a bit to the left. Yeah, that should look fine. Perfect. Okay, new day, new project. Now let's put this. So the other day I was thinking of adding a new project to add to the streams. And I had a couple leftovers that I never continued. So I left it to a poll, and several people chose this. An entry I made for a Game Boy theme, Game Jam. That's... Let's show it first, to see what this it is about. I should add the audio. I wonder if it's this one. Let's see. Yeah. I have to remember how to play this. Alright. Your typical shmup in a way, but it's also more of a defense type of game. Because not only you have to defeat the enemies, you also have to stop the attack from reaching the edge of the screen. It's a bit chaotic to explain while playing, but that's the main idea. Now, where do I hide this? Here, I have to hide this. Not that. Not this. Which ones are the buttons? Is it this? Yeah, fortunately I cannot hide this, but... But yeah, the idea is that your player has to protect this object, which will be your station, from the enemy attacks. So not only you have to shoot them, you have to deflect in a way the projectiles so they not reach your protection target. And this happens in a set of enemy webs. In between each web, you can use the currency you earn from defeating the enemies to upgrade your ship or to heal the goal, let's say. So it's a constant resource management issue with, do I use this to improve myself and defeat enemies faster, or do I heal it to last longer? And all of this was made in, I think it was 1 week for the gaming jam. So yeah, in that I have to rush a couple of things, improvise a lot, not optimize many things. So it will be nice to refine this in a way to add all the things that I couldn't do on time, and to realize all these errors. Yeah, this is one of the things I was talking about. So that's basically the game in a nutshell. Now before going right into the game, I do have to plan this out a bit. So here we have the original game. So originally the game, since it's made for a Game Boy screen, it has a... I forgot already. So not exactly a huge size for the window, for the overchase and the UI. So after doing some research, I decided to improve the screen to a 640 by 360. I think it was that. Yeah. This should give me a nice 16:9 ratio. That way I can expand the screen to all the common resolutions for monitor like 720, 1080 and all of that. Should make the scaling for pixels look smooth. Now as for the gameplay itself, let's better use this. So up here we have the up here below we have the UI. With health and the energy for the reflection. Should make it smaller because part of the energy bar includes this small bar that when it's filled will recharge one instance of the battery. Of energy, which can be recharged by staying near the enemy projectiles or grazing. It's something that I took from Toho. I thought it was really a neat feature to have. We have the currency. And the status of the wave and all that. And here we have the health of the station. If only I was able to draw further lines, but oh well. So we have that, now we have the station itself. Player ship, which I would really like to improve because it was too improvised and I had no idea how to draw a mech, which will be a nice thing to learn. Let's make it simple as possible. Let's pretend this is the player ship. And this will be the enemies. And they will come in a number of waves in different patterns and different types. Now a bigger screen will need more space to patterns and types of enemies, and also it will help improve the graphics, which is another important thing I wanted to do, to not completely replace the Game Boy Color, but maybe stick to 3 or 4 colors for each component of the game. So for example, let's say that for the player and the station, they could both have one color palette, let's say, but we'll be limited to focus on that. The same for the enemies. They will be shaped differently but share the same colors. And the same goes for the UI. And when we are right, let's say the same for the background. That this will give a lot of more variety visually, but at the same time have some restraints. Now the thing is, I still haven't started drawing none of the elements, and I still also don't have any palettes looked up yet. I did browse a bit but didn't choose any. So mostly the stream will be planning and deciding what will I use. Let's call it a production stream. There will probably be some programming, but it'll mostly be deciding what to do in all of the cases. Now, having said that, I'll put this on the side. And let's try starting a bit on this game. Actually, let's go back to the whiteboard, because we have to organize a bit how will this game be, because as you can see on the original game, everything is on the same object, which is definitely not good. All the waves are already made, all the objects are instanced, which for a game jam, when you have some limits on time, it can be overlooked, but if you want to make it a proper game, I have to be, let's say, professional about this. Okay, so let's go back to this. Now let's start on the proper game scene set. As we saw, there will be the station, which will be the main focus on the game, because you have to protect it. You have the player ship. And the enemies here. We have enough to host them, all of them. That will be handled by instancing, controlling if there's any left or not. So let's call it enemies for now. Yeah, we have all the instances of enemy. Now, separate from this, we'll also have the UI. Now the UI here. What's behaving like that? We have the top and the bottom part. The top will have the player health, and the energy. Now, it will also have this bar below. Now let's call it energy point charge. Also we have the currency. And for now, to keep track, let's have a web counter. Also, at the bottom, we have the station HP. Now about the movable objects, we have the player and the enemies. Both will be a type of ship. So let's call it here. If we have an HP variable, I call HP instead of life or anything else because it's shorter. So just for namesake. It will be able to move, so we'll have a velocity, which includes an acceleration and a maximum speed. So because they can get hit, we'll have a hitbox. And not every ship will be able to shoot, so I don't know if should keep that here on the other objects. So maybe I should pull it spawners because they can have more than one point to shoot, so that should be an important distinction. Now this will be common behavior to all of them, so separately we have the player. Now what does the player have different? It has the energy points and a race zone, which will be the area around which, if there's a projectile nearby, it will charge the board. I think it was like this much. So they involve taking some risks to recharge that. Then we have the enemy, which has a herd bots. So if the player of the station touches any of them, they will deal damage. Also, they have a pattern in the follow that it was seen in the game. They will move in this way, and each one will have a different one. Also, or at least most of them will have a different projectile to shoot. So I don't know if I should add that here. Now as for the wave handling, let's see how it was originally made. Maybe we should leave all of that to a different instance. Something like a wave handler. That way the enemies only focus on instancing them and starting them. Because delegating too much to a single not going to travel later. you have to decide if the enemy, the hunter's enemies also handles when to send each wave, or does it focus only on the current wave? Because let's see, how many did I have here? Because here we have 7 waves and the boss. So yeah, maybe I'll could rename this to Wave Hunter, and yeah, should probably be for the best, since you will need the information. In that case, let's do this. And delete this. What else should I write down so I don't forget? The station the Dracona can make later. Maybe we should leave the projectiles and explosions in a separate layer. This is starting to look like I'm redoing exactly as it is, but shouldn't be like that. Because I guess overall it wasn't that bad, just too much things, too many things in one node. Maybe move around a couple of things, but more than that. Because the thing about leaving projectiles in a different node is that way, when a level is complete or it's time to set the game over, all the projectiles are destroyed so that they don't continue existing in the game and cause some trouble. So let's do that. Same way with explosion, but let's call it effect. Now, all of this will live inside the main node that will be above all of this. That main node, we have the title, options, and all of that. To move smoothly between all of them. Okay, for now, today let's start with making the basic player move on the screen. That should be nice to have for starters. So that it's not all planning. Okay, so got the player. You can move in all 8 directions. Originally, I wanted to have it so the player could shoot in 3 different directions, each one with a different button. But I was never totally convinced of that. So for now, let's leave it in one direction. Also, it can deploy the reflector. So I may not look like much, but when you're in the game, it can be a little too complicated to remember that you have all of these features to do. When your main focus is to mostly protect the station more than killing the enemies. But one of the features that I wanted to have on the game was a, let's call it, special skill. Basically, if you had a full bar, you could deploy one to make a shield on the station that would block a number of hits from the enemy. So it was either for defense, or you could choose one for offense, which will make you shoot a number of missiles towards the enemies. This was an idea that was scrapped for the game jam, but maybe we could add that as a sort of last resource. Now, since you can upgrade the player, the setup doubt is if do I leave that to the player object or do I leave it outside since it can be edited by the game when you upgrade it. So for that, since that will be reset every time you start a new game, it's probably best left to have that inside the game. Or maybe on your global object. Since that will be accessed by the player, the UI, and all of that. So yeah, I think that's for now all we can do. So with that out of the way, I'll put this aside. So let's start coding a bit. I have to move these files. So let's create a folder. Right before this. Let's make the parent class here. And let's give it the variables that we were talking about earlier. So we have an integer for the HP. Which is setter and getters. And also let's set the signal for that, that way if anything needs this, like the player for example for the HP bar, we can set this here. Next the velocity. This is better too because it can move in new all the X and Y axis. And for its part to be able to change easily. Let's leave it like that, and I think he was an integer, let's see. Yeah, it was. Now the thing about the graphics is that it will depend because some may have one sprite, others may have some animation. So for now let's put a placeholder like a simple sprite for the graphics. Then we have say this collision shape to for the hitbox. I know that I think about it, was it a node or it was a kinematic body? I wonder if it was the same for the enemies. Yeah, I forgot that. So let's change its type. Like this. Now we have that. And let's change. Ah, it's already named hitbox. Okay. We'll leave this empty because this will depend on what's the shape of the ship itself. But also let's leave 2D. For now let's leave one, let's call it bullet spawner. And this should be the basis of the ship itself. What else? I don't think there's much else to do. We can edit this later if we need. So now let's make an object that inherits this. And let's call it player. Let's leave it like this. Actually, let's make a new folder for this. And let's pass on the graphics. Give me a second, just in case. Was here. And let's re-import this so it doesn't look as blurry. Okay, so I'll move this here. I wonder if I should look up now or later colors for this ship, because I also have to look up some references to know what to draw. Let's make some folders. We have the game scene, which is where the main gameplay will happen. And let's already instance the player to have a measure of how it will look. Now this is the it's already set up to have the window size we wanted. But it still kind of looks small, let's say. Because also we haven't taken into account the size for the UI. We don't know how much it will occupy yet. Actually, let's start setting that up. Let's have the main scene. And let's instance the game object. Also, here we have the main UI. Which will occupy the entire screen. Now, just from this partition, it's starting to look like we could have this for the top part and this for the bottom. It looks like it will give us enough space. At least compared to how it was originally. Because if we compare how big was it? Let's see, here it's 24 in height versus 64. That's already more than double. Also, I do would like to make the sprite bigger to have some detail. Because right now the sprite is... it's this small. I would like it to be at least twice. Actually, let's see. Yeah, that looks better. Okay. I can need a 48x48 perhaps. Okay, that looks big enough, and with plenty of space on screen also. Because I don't want it to cover the entire screen either, I want to leave some space to move around. Also, this will help because having more horizontal space to move around will give you more time to react to the projectiles. So that would be a nice help too. Now this leaves a space to have a station here. Maybe halfway. Now let's put that as a placeholder for now. Let's see. Actually, no. Let's have that here. Like that. Almost. Yeah, that should be fine. Okay, enough playing around, let's already start making the player move. So for this... I do like to be able to use the controller to take advantage of the analog stick. So for that, let's just name the basics. Okay, now let's see. Let's start with the basic process. Let's put these numbers to start as reference. Actually, this should be an integer because the direction will be set by the controller. At least that's how I remember it. While I was looking at this, I could move the reflector to its own object. That would help things a bit to have everything more separate. Now these functions, I can request them for a move towards the home centrality with Godo on the scripting. Okay, I'm getting too much into this, I have to focus on the basic movement first. So let's pass this function. Now for the hits, we'll see right minus left, I think. Yeah. And same thing for the y axis. Now about this, let's see. Yeah, I think I'll show it on it's normalized. Wait, this didn't go here. We do will need these functions here. Oh, hey, Shackle. Godono has matches. Oh, that's from the new version, the 3.4.5. I still didn't look into many of the new functions, so I was unaware. Wait, let me check. Oh, this is new, right? Ah, no wonder. I haven't looked too much into that yet. Thanks. Yeah, this will definitely save some time. Yeah, I just noticed it's a shame, but it's not the end of the world. Now the thing is, I just noticed there's also one for get tripod axis. That's no different, right? Okay, we have the axes, so let's get here. I cannot remember if I used this or not. Ah, here. Edit. For now, let's just set a flat number for the speed and we'll add the maximum minimum. This should be enough to start, let's see. Yeah, okay. Now I separate that with... this. It was like this. Because this way I can change it faster. Or maybe not. I think it was like this. Now if I do this, it should be the same. Okay. But if I do this, yeah, now the thing is, I have to able to deaccelerate. Actually, it should be faster. acceleration is really faster than the match speed. Or at least not as slow. Might as well add the friction. Like this. So which was the function to see if the vector was zero? There was one. Let's just say like this for now. What am I missing here? Right, it's still applying this, that's right. Maybe like this? No. Not doing anything. Okay, so how do I make it so that continues moving, you know, and I'm not pressing a button? And how was it? Like this? No. This might not get it right. Let's see. But this. Hmm. If like zero dot is alright, I know it's set in motion. Because it's zero. Yeah, but the thing about that is that it will never have a cap. I'm already setting the maximum speed with the velocity that will be an integer that this will be multiplied to the direction inputs. And the thing about that is that I'm already capping the velocity sort motion loop. Yeah, but the thing about that is that the reason for having this is that it should cap the maximum movement speed that it will have. So I rather avoid having to clamp the value twice. I'm trying to remember how I did it on the platformer. Trying to think if I did it in a different way. But motion needs to be applied before it can be capped. What if I apply that here too? Like this. Motion will prevent the picture when zero. Right, that was my intention with applying this. But I guess I had to apply it twice in the end. So it'll be something like this. But in that case, I should already do everything in one variable. Maybe that's the solution. Maybe I don't need an acceleration after all. Oh, I cannot do that. At least not with that function. I can. I see. And it's not moving either. Am I missing something? Maybe it's not this. No. It should be because I'm applying it here. First it says 0 and on each frame. If the move, if there is moving the axis, it will apply it. It will go towards this match value. Actually, let me try something else. To not clutter the console. It's never moving. So it's setting 0. So then does this need gold? It does. So at least I do know the function is entering. It's not that it's resetting. Ah, god damn it. You're right. How did I overlook that? I was too focused on applying the function, I didn't notice I was missing that. Here is where. And actually, you don't need that for the friction because it will keep the same direction. Of course, because I'm always multiplying by zero. So of course it's never gonna change. So how do I set this the first time? Should be this. That the ticket. That was an issue. Now we have some sort of smooth movement. Now you have to fine tune the variables. It should basically be like that. Okay, perfect. So it's working now. Let's increase the acceleration. Much friction for a shmup. The movement should be snappier, I think. So let's add that. Get double the value. And of course I forgot to apply that. Maybe a bit more like that. Yeah, that's perfect. Can we wait? It does kind of feel a bit rigid, so maybe with more acceleration. Okay, that's starting to feel much better. Okay, I do have to take a bit of a break, just a couple minutes. I'll be right back. Thank you. Alright, I am back. Now, we have a moving player, so I guess the next basic thing will be to make it shoot to have most of the functionality ready. So here, actually, I should write down
that's project plan thing.
Let's twin that thing again. Swear, I wish I knew why it breaks like that. Let's see. Because I have to close and open it every time, it's really annoying. Okay, so air projectile. It should have a velocity. Which can be straight, or if it's a homing missile. No wait, this should be an integer because the velocity will be constant. That is for sure. What should be next? It's a target type. Either a player or the enemy. And what else? Let's see here. Okay, yeah. This will be a perception projectile then. We have the bullets. And the missile. Which you have a concrete target. And a steer speed. This way the bullets will move in one direction and the missile will home in towards the designated target or position. It kind of looks like overkill for such a simple thing, but if I want to scale this up later and add more things, this could be a good approach. Now, on the game, let's make a should be what kind of note should be? I guess I could make it actually an area. Sure, let's go with that. Pass to me. Now both have the same components. The graphic sprite and the hitbox. Which I should make its own object later on, because that's a common component the ships also have. Actually, let's see. Did I make it a separate thing? No. Well, for now, let's leave it like that. So later on, I will. Because for now, there will be no collision to check, so. But I will make it a larger component later on. And now it's just to remember that they all have one. Okay, and let's make a script for this. I keep forgetting how to make it so that sport could be a selectable string. Let's see, did I already make that here? I like that. An elastic function move. This place will be a common function to have that should be called on every frame. Okay, we have this. Let's make it a bullet. And save it here. Since we also have the graphics. Like that, and let's make it bigger.